live from Etheridge Stadium. Coug Sportsnet, in conjunction with Texas Sports Radio Network, presents your Lamar Cougars, the Lamar Cougars, I should say, as they start the 2016 season against the Raiders of Houston Sterling High School. The gang's back, everybody. Brandon Williams, along with Mike Lockwood, Lewis Perry Jr., senior stats down on the field. Guys, it has been a long and trying 8 months, but we're back. Football is alive and well in Lamarck, gentlemen.
Lamarck hasn't been on this field since mid-November of last year. I'm sorry, late October of last year. It's good to have Cougars at Etheridge Stadium. Cougar Nation alive and well. We've got a good crowd outside. It's a new district. It's even a new division. Let's hope it's the same domination.
And guys, it's a new outlook, everything. The merger between Lamarck and Texas City is nothing but good for both sides. I mean, the facilities are getting better, the equipment's getting better, the outlook is getting better, the way that everybody's starting to look at Lamarck is say, hey, the sleeping giant is back. And I tell you guys, I'm so excited. I'm like with Mayor Hawken here. He said it's been the longest day in his life waiting for this 7 o'clock kickoff. So guys, I tell you, this is going to be a great season. Everything that was behind us is behind us. It's all looking at the windshield, no more looking at the rearview mirror.
And as we did mention earlier, we are going to be airing live online with Texas Sports Radio Network. I'd like to thank Lynn Michaels and also Dan Morgan of Lamarck High School to help us out. You will be able to catch those games online, tsrn.com. Go to the homepage, you'll be able to catch us from there. We are going to take a commercial break because we've got a national anthem, and after that, we will have captains and a kickoff in the 2016 season. Thank goodness, we'll finally be underway. Coug Sportsnet back here at Etheridge Stadium as we are moments away from kickoff, the 2016 regular season opener between your Lamarck Cougars and the Sterling Raiders of Houston. Take a quick look at Sterling. Last year, 5-6, they made the playoffs, but were bounced out by Stafford, 49-26 in the first round. They do bring a lot of talent back to the table, Lewis, especially when you look at their offensive weapons.
They've got a really nice running back, or they've got a couple of really nice running backs in, and I'm not even going to try and pronounce his name, McKenshawa.
Good enough.
And that's a fun one. He's followed up by David Burton. The two of those two guys are going to be leading their ground game, and we're going to see how they go at against it against a Lamarck defense that really didn't even have to retool a whole lot. They brought back a good number of starters.
Seven starters from last season, including your All-State linebacker in DeMarco Guidry.
I just got to talk about it. Didn't mean to interrupt, but DeMarco Guidry, guys, I think this is going to be the man. It's going to be the playmaker. He's going to be the statement of a Lamarck Cougars this year, I do believe.
Yeah, both offensively and defensively.
Correct.
He's going to be the featured running back this year for the Cougars.
Brandon, a quick little rundown maybe if you want to talk about maybe the new we got some new receivers before we start the game. Talk about receivers, quarterback, some of our key playmakers.
Lots of new faces. We're going to certainly get used to them. We'll start at quarterback. It's going to be Miles Lanius. He will be wearing number 7. He is a junior transfer from Caldwell and has looked sharp during 7-on-7 season and also during training camp as well. So he is going to get the nod at quarterback. As you mentioned, lots of new faces at wide receiver, but if you're a basketball fan of Lamarck, some of these guys are going to be familiar. You know, you look at Jerron Freeman. He'll be wearing number 2. You're going to see a lot of him as well, along with number 23, Raymond Stubblefield, who's going to be playing tight end on the offensive side.
Let's get these captains right quick, guys. Sorry to interrupt you there.
No problem.
Brandon, if you get the Lamarck captain, I got number 99.
Number 99, of course, is Marlon Ford. Number 3, DeMarco Guidry.
It's like we got number 11.
Number 11, that is going to be Jaden Bishop.
Number 33.
And number 33, that is going to be Alan Franklin.
Brandon, Lewis, you got a 52?
52 is Quentin White.
55 and 1.
55 is Ian Gilbert, and 1 is Darius Weathers, and
guys,
that's for Sterling.
Here we go.
Indeed. You took a look, and you mentioned Weathers. He is going to be rotating at quarterback this evening, along with the number 3, Christian Weaver. Weathers was their lead quarterback last season, threw 14 touchdown passes, but also had a bit of an issue with the INT bug. He threw 21 of them. So the Cougars would like to take advantage of his proneness to throwing to different colored jerseys.
All right, we're going to get to see Lamarck's offense on the field first, as Sterling's going to be kicking off to the Cougars to start this game at first quarter.
You know, look back deep for Lamarck. It will be number 11, Bishop. Also Franklin, number 33. And looks like it's going to be number 4.
Back deep for the Cougars.
Perry Preston.
Guys, look at the field tonight, Brandon. I'm sorry.
Yes.
But the field is beautiful. I mean, we've got a beautiful night. I mean, what a wonderful way to start this season. Like I say, new beginnings, and, I mean, the stands look great. The crowd's starting to file in. Beautiful way to start the
year. Number one, Darius Weathers.
Weathers is a set to kick off, and we are moments away from the 2016 season officially coming underway, and we are on it. It's going to be a line drive kick. It looks like it'll be picked up by Limones. And he's going to be stopped at around the 28-yard line, and that is where the Cougars will start for the first time this season. As we mentioned, Miles Longius, number 7, is your quarterback. Perry Preston is in the backfield, number 4, along with DeMarco Guidry, number 3. Also on the field, Jaden Bishop, number 11, and number 6, Limones at receiver. Well, bit of an offset eye look for Lamarck. You'll get two men in motion. We'll bring it over to the strong side, and it's Stubblefield and Bishop. And it's going to be a swing to Perry, and it's going to be Perry breaking a couple of tackles, and Perry Preston with a nice run. That's going to gain about 8, maybe 9 yards on that play. To see where they put him out, they put him down at the 38-yard line, and that is going to be about a yard short of a first down. So second down and one, and the Cougs going with a traditional no-huddle set. Lonius under center. Bishop the fullback, and they will hand it to Guidry, and Guidry is going to be stuffed immediately. A host of white jerseys swarming in, and that's number 52, Quentin White, number 54,
number
Corey
three,
White
on the carry.
There with the stop, so he was stuffed. First carry of the season, no gain, so make it third down and a short yard to go for the Cougars. They will spread the ball out now with number 10, Cordell Stewart, in one of the slot sets, along with Freeman, number 2, in a slot, and it'll be Longius calling his own number, and he will find his way, and he'll get the first down.
Big push by that offensive line.
And that is going to be a huge key this season for the Lamarck Cougars, and how well that offensive line gels is really going to determine how efficient this offense will be.
We'll try to get those names in here in a little bit, guys.
First and 10. It'll break down in shotgun formation now. It'll be a handoff this time. It is going to be Guidry. And Guidry, not much success there again, as the Raiders swarming in.
Two.
A huge loss there.
Three.
Number 7 in there. Don't have a name on him, but he was in there along with number 54 again, Ja'Cory White. A loss of 3 for Guidry. So second down and 13 to go. All set out formation. Swin set to the near side. Lots of movement. And it looks like that could be Lamarck.
Oh, it will be.
So
first game jitters.
Take a look at the offensive line. We'll go ahead and get these guys in a moment.
I got number 79.
79 is going to be Ahmad Josie.
58.
Number 58, that's going to be Herschel Wafer.
Number 50.
50, Pedro Rubio handling center position this season.
59,
Kenneth Cobb,
78.
Freshman, and number 78, James Lofton.
Brings up second and long.
So the offensive line struggling a little bit early on. As Lonius will drop back, steps up. That ball is going to be swatted back. Good stop, good deflection there on the play.
That number?
Number looks like number 57.
57, yep.
It's like we had a screen pass that was being tried to be set up, guys.
Looked like it was, but number 57 there on the play.
We don't have a name for that player, but it was a good play.
So third down and 13 coming up.
Third down and 18.
Third and 18. Sorry about that. Even longer.
I wish it was 13.
Be interesting if he picks up 10 yards or 11 yards if he goes for it on fourth.
We'll move Guidry around in a two tight end set. Four-man front. They show blitz. Lonnie is back. Has pressure. Steps up. Throws. And throwing to no one in particular as the pressure coming in hot and heavy. So after the first down by the Cougars, they will go three and out as it will be fourth down and long. And we will see the punting unit for the first time. Back deep for Sterling. Number three, Richard Hatsala.
Who we got number 18 doing the punting duties?
Number 18 for the Cougars this season will be Jalen Walker, senior, will be handling the punting duties. But Sawa lined up at around his own 31-yard line. Gets a good snap and a punt that'll take a bit of a Cougar bounce and will die down around the 32. So at the end of the day, it's not going to get much as the ball will be down to the 31-yard line. Gain of 35 on that punt.
Raiders begin first and 10 from the 31-yard line.
So first and 10 for Sterling with 9:28 to go here in the first quarter.
Who was that the first ball carry that picked up the good game for Lamar?
Preston Perry.
Yeah, it'll be Preston Perry. Always have his name
Preston
in reverse.
Yeah, we do.
Preston, yeah, we always do it. They always do it for some reason.
Oh, so it is Perry Preston.
Yes.
Okay. Good. I'm going to read it the way it was up here.
Shotgun set for the Raiders. And only a stoppage of play. And
they
will have to wait just a bit for Weathers to get going. Take a look and see what the call is going to be. That is going to be a false start that is going to push them back.
This receiver over here on the near side, number seven, we don't have a name for him.
We got a little bit happy on that one.
For our TSRN listening audience, we're here live at Etheridge Stadium. We're at 9 minutes, 27 seconds here into this first quarter on a beautiful opening game night.
Weather swings it out, pass is complete, and that is going to be a catch made by number two, and that is going to be their leading man, Frank Brown, and Brown coming off a strong season last year where he led the team in rushing with 478 yards.
Got everything from the penalty plus two, so it's going to be bringing it up to second down and eight.
So swing pass again, and that is going to be reception made by number three, Matsawa.
He just takes that ball and just kind of shovels it out there, doesn't he, guys?
Yep. Yeah, he does, and that might explain the reason why he's interception prone. Ball doesn't look like it has a lot of zip in it.
Exactly.
Very casual throw, and that time Jerry Evans was right there on that man whenever he made the catch.
So it'll be a third down and about four and movement all over the place.
I'm afraid that one's might be on us.
And that'll probably be right at a first down territory.
Encroachment, and should be enough for a first down.
We're real close.
They're going to ask for a measurement on that one? No, that's actually, they're calling it still fourth. No, they're
giving it a first.
Yeah, it'll be a first.
First down. Ball up at the 41-yard line now.
First and 10 for the Cougars. So wait for a moment to get everybody lined up.
Let that official get back into the backfield again.
First and 10. Weathers in a shotgun set. He's got three wide receivers to the far side. Back, has time, looking, flushed out. He's just going to throw this thing up for grabs, and that ball is going to be somehow caught inside the 10, inside the 5, and somehow, someway, number 10, Bobby Davis. With the reception, and they will down him at the 5-yard line. Make that a 54-yard reception for Davis.
Those of you listening to this broadcast, that ball was just heaved up in the air on a wing and a prayer. Looked like the Lamarck defender was going to intercept it just outside his outreach fingers.
That was Freeman on the attempted interception. Withers is going to throw the ball, and that is going to be a touchdown. That looks like number three, Matsawa, with the reception. It is.
Once again, the quarterback throws it over the outstretched hands of Lamarck defenders right into the hands of a waiting receiver at the back of the end zone.
So 7 minutes, 54 seconds to go in the first quarter. It is going to be Sterling striking first. 5-yard touchdown pass.
Going for two here, guys.
It looks like they are going shotgun set. Weather's rolling out. See if he can try to strike lightning again. He'll try to run for it.
He got it.
And looks like he did.
Haven't seen
it. No, he did. Yeah, They'll confirm it.
He laid the ball down on the ground right there at the goal line.
So just like that, Sterling needed only five plays to go 69 for a touchdown.
What was that pass, 50 plus?
54 yards. It's a 54-yard reception to Bobby Davis. So with 7:54 to go, first quarter, it is Sterling 8, Lamarck nothing. Cougs Sports Net will be right back. 4 seconds to go in the first quarter. It is Lamarck trailing Sterling by a count of 8-0. Weathers will handle the kicking. And back deep for Lamarck, it will be again Preston in the middle, followed by Franklin to the near side and Bishop to the far. We'll see if Weathers will attempt to go back deep again, and here we go.
Oh, good catch.
Demonis looks like we'll try to do a little trick oration, and it might work just a bit. We'll get better field position as Perry Preston will return the ball to around the 37-yard line. So the Cougars will get their second drive of the night. Flag is down at around the 40-yard line.
No, that's the one I was talking about. That's at towel.
Oh, same towel, okay.
There we go. Yeah, that twice I've seen that. You know, last time I remember seeing Lamarck try to play a little bit of that trickery on kickoff, Brian Irwin was on the field. Y'all remember that guy?
Exactly. First and 10. They'll run the toss to Guidry, and Guidry is going to be crowd, though. Tries to turn the corner, breaks the tackle, tries to go upfield, got a block, still moving, and he will churn and make what looked like it would be disaster to about a 5-yard gain.
Now, he had to travel about 40 yards to get that 5 yards, and he had to break a couple of tackles and make a couple of nice cuts. But when everything is said and done, that's a 3-yard gain.
Well, and without any kind of extra adjectives, that young man is an athlete, guys.
He is, and he is heading to UT San Antonio, committed in June. So he is going to be a road runner next season. Lonius will hand the ball off again, and it'll be Guidry. He'll be stopped at around the 45-yard line. Got about two on that carry. Tackle made by number 54, Ja'Cory White.
Offensive line still trying to work with that chemistry of the handoff and the runners coming up on the blocks.
Third down and two for the Cougars.
Lonius under center this time.
Only a counter play to Guidry, and Guidry's got room, and Guidry's got a first down and more, and that's vintage DeMarco Guidry there.
Yep, stand up straight, power running.
Powered
11-yard gain.
And that will move the chains for a first down.
Ball inside Sterling territory at the 42-yard line. First down. 6:35 in this first quarter, 0-0 tie. Lamarck Cougars opening home game against Houston Sterling.
That's except at 7-0.
I'm sorry, 7-0. Let me
8-0.
Yes, sir.
8-0.
We got all get first game.
And that is going to be a false start. Yep. It's Lamarck. Somebody move.
Down here on the near side.
All right, that's what shot us in the foot on that first series, guys.
You know, push them back 5 yards.
Start called against the
so make it first down and 15. It will spot the ball at the 47-yard line up Sterling. And again, more movement, and that's going to push things back another 5. And the youth and inexperience of this young line certainly showing, and it's not in for the positive thus far, as that makes it the third false start penalty by the Cougars, so it's going to make it first down and 20.
Actually, you had a defender that made the move, and then the Lamarck offensive lineman didn't keep his stance. He reacted to that movement, and he's the one that made the false start.
So first down and 20. Cougars will have to get the ball to the 32 of Sterling to get the first down. Lonnie is back. Halftime steps up downfield. Ball is going to be intercepted. Ball is picked off, and he's got room to run. That is number 5, Terrence Brown, and Terrence Brown is going to go the distance for a touchdown. 63-yard return for the Raiders, who now take a 14-0 lead with the point after coming.
All right, there's only so often we're going to be able to say jitters, first game jitters, and write it off. They're going to have to step it up now.
We're still all right, guys.
Oh, yeah.
Not what you expect at the first 6 minutes and 19 seconds of the contest, but the Cougars showing a little bit of the inexperience, especially on the offensive side, as Sterling set to attempt their second conversion of the evening.
So this young Cougar team has been plagued by penalties on both sides, defense and offense, and now you got the turnover.
Pistol set for Weathers as he will roll out, steps up, throws, has a man, and he will get it in. We'll see who that is, but it doesn't matter because the bottom line is that it's 16-0. Sterling leading over Lamarck, 5:41 to go first quarter. Cougs Sports Net TSRN will be right back. Seconds to go first quarter. Cougars down 16-0 after a 63-yard interception return by Terrence Brown. Weather set to kick off. It'll be Preston, number 4 in the middle. Jaden Bishop is number 11 to the far side. To your near side is number 33, Allen Franklin. We'll see if they can kick the ball deep. They squibbed it for the first two kicks.
Yeah, they haven't made an attempt to put the ball downfield yet.
No reason to take a risk on the return game, and that is going to be kicked a little further out. He'll be fielded by Preston and around the 14-yard line. He'll cut it back to the 30. Still going to the 35, to the 40, 45-yard line. So a nice return.
Number 4, Preston Perry on the return.
By Perry Preston. And yeah, see, even the PA guy got burned.
I told you.
I just heard that one as well. Yep.
Young man just says, call me number 4.
Perry returns the ball. Number 4, so the ball will be spotted at the 45-yard line. First and 10 for the Cougars.
All right, Miss Alania, shake it off. Plenty of ball game.
Cougs will go into the ring set, and we've got to stop to play. And it looks like it will be a timeout for Lamarck. Actually, it's going to be against Sterling. So we'll go ahead and take it with them. 5 minutes, 33 seconds to go first quarter. It is Sterling 16, Lamarck nothing, Cougs Sports Net TSRN.
First and 10 for the Cougars at the 45-yard line. Cougs are going into their wing set.
It'll be a handoff to Guidry, and Guidry is going to plow his way to around midfield, probably to around the 49-yard line. So a nice gain of 6 on the carry for Guidry.
That was a real patient run, too, as he hit that line. There was a no hole there. He hesitated for just a quick second.
Second down and 5 for the Cougars.
And then was able to get through there and gain that 5 yards.
Second down and 5 at midfield, they'll call it. We'll go to wing set. Number 11, Bishop. Number 17, Jerry Evans. Or in the wings, as long as adjust the play. And it'll be a handoff to Guidry. Guidry tries to turn the corner, tries to get a block, got forward, bulldozes a couple of defenders, and that will get the ball inside Sterling territory to around the 36-yard line. So that's a 14-yard gain.
Down to the 37-yard line, and that's
he put on some muscle Cougar since last year, guys.
He has. He looks completely different. Always a big, strong guy, but he looked completely different during the offseason.
That first man that came up to him, he just put a hand on his helmet and pushed him away.
It's like Coach Jackson describes best with him. He just runs angry.
You'll get a bit of a breather as it's going to be Preston in the backfield. And it'll be a handoff to Preston. And Preston hits the hole, plows forward to around the 32-yard line. So a gain of about five on that play. So they'll get the ball to around the 31-yard line.
Preston makes makes a little bit quicker cuts.
He's the lightning.
Yes, he is.
Second down, ball at the 31-yard line. Evans goes in motion. Movement.
It should be a free play.
Lonnie took advantage of it. He stopped short of the first down, but they will go ahead and accept that penalty, which should give them the first.
4:14 here in this first quarter. Sterling is struck quickly on long pass and then also an interception, up 16-0. Lamarck driving now.
So that will move the ball to the 26-yard line and a new set of downs for the Cougars with 4 minutes and 14 seconds left in the first quarter. Cougars trying to begin to erase a 16-0 deficit.
By far the deepest they've penetrated in only the third drive. Yep, still 4 minutes and 11 seconds to go in the first quarter.
Well, if they get rid of those penalties, this offense is looking pretty good.
Offensive line, we mentioned, you know, it's going to need a little time to gel. There's size and there's talent, but the cohesiveness is going to need some work. And it'll be Lanius back, steps up, throws downfield, has a man, complete, good deflection.
Number three,
Hatsawa, with a nice deflection at the last minute. He was looking for number 23, Raymond Stubblefield.
And Stubblefield had about a yard behind him, and that was just a really good play by that defensive
back.
It was a well-thrown ball, guys.
The well-thrown ball. It was not underthrown. It was on the mark, but the, like you say, the defender did make a good move.
Wasn't for the last ditch tip. It's six. Second down and 10 at the 26-yard line. 3:48 to go. Preston in motion. It'll be Preston.
Oh,
he's
going to
turn
the
corner. He's got the 15. He's got the 10. He'll go out of bounds inside the 10-yard line. Looks like they will spot him down at the 6.
Boy, did he hit daylight in a hurry, guys.
Beautiful trickeration on that one as he let everyone fool. Spot the ball at the 5-yard line, make it first and goal for the Cougars. First and goal for Lamarck. Ball is at the 5-yard line. Bishop in motion, a handoff to Guidry. Guidry's gonna break a couple of tackles. He'll swing his way.
Yeah.
Does the last effort count? Will they give it to him?
Nope, not quite.
I think the knee was down. Yeah, I think the knee was down before the ball crossed the plane.
A great effort there by Guidry. It's gonna put the Cougars in second down and goal at the 1-yard line. See if Lonnie will look and call his own number. He will, and he'll scoot in.
Yeah, he went in behind. He burrowed under.
No, they're going to say the knee's down.
Knee went down
just before the goal line. I was wondering if they would see it.
Yeah, that's what I was kind of hoping they wouldn't too, but.
Yeah, he did go burrow down, so you're right. So his knee was down just as before he crossed the plane. All right, brings up a short in inches.
So third down and goal just inside the one. He'll try to get it. This time it'll work.
All right. Mom and Daddy Lonnius, welcome back to Lamarck. Your son had just scored the first touchdown of the 2016 football season.
So the Cougs on the board for the first time in 2016 with 2 minutes, 57 seconds to go in the first quarter. As it's now 16-6, point after pending. And it looks like it will be Pedro Rubio lining up the well.
Here we go for two.
Try to cut this lead to half. Rubio is normally your kicker. He's lined up under center. He'll go in motion. He'll trap Preston, and Preston's going to pull his way in the end zone.
Put that helmet down. Knock the defender back.
So the Cougs strike back. Beautiful 55-yard drive capped off by the 1-yard scoring run from Lonnius. Preston gets the 2-point run, so in 2 minutes, 57 seconds to go in the first quarter. The score is now cut in half. It is Lamarck trailing Sterling by a count of 16-8. Cougs Sports Net, TSRN, will be right back.
A squib kick, and it's going to be short. And it looks like they will retain the football. Whistle blew a little bit earlier, but nonetheless, Sterling is able to hold on to the ball. That was number 15, Thomas Reed.
Failed the first time.
So Sterling with the football at their own 35-yard line.
Now what we need is the defense now, guys, to step up. Only 2:57 left in this first quarter, but Lamarck has got the momentum going after that last score, and they really have not been outplayed up to this point. It's just that they've given up the big pass, and they gave up the interception.
Eight plays, 55 yards accounted for that drive, and it was Preston and Guidry combining for 48 of those yards. Each of them with a combined five carries. Guidry had three of them, Perry had two. So first down, 10 to go for the Raiders at the 35-yard line. We'll get things going with 2:57 to go here in the first quarter. Withers gets the man in motion, and it'll be a handoff to number 44 for the Raiders, and that is going to be Clifton Evans. Big kid, 5'9", 225.
Let's get some of the guys across front defensive line. Right,
okay,
quick.
Indeed.
Number 99.
We'll go ahead. Number 99, that is going to be Marlon Ford, of course.
75.
Number 75 will be Norian Saldana.
Number 10.
Number 10 will be Cordell Stewart.
Number 24.
With number 24 being Derek Middleton on your ends.
We'll get the rest, yeah.
Second down and around 8 on that play.
Like a little bit of motion.
Weathers back, throws up, looking. Ball is going to be caught. And then it'll be a reception made by number 3, Matsawa. He has been a busy young man here in the first quarter.
Yeah, he has.
On both sides of the ball.
How is he coming down with these big play passes, guys?
That is what Sterling lives and dies on. They don't throw, they don't complete passes at a high percentage. But when they hit, they hurt. And that has really been their mantra over the past several years.
We talked about that low velocity, high looping pass that he's throwing. He's giving the receivers plenty of time to run underneath them.
So that was a gain of 20.
There we go.
The gain of 32, but that's an interception.
I saw a flag go down.
There is a flag, yep.
Flag down, and if it stands, it's an interception by Kevin Jackson. And it looks like it's coming back with the way that the Raiders against Lamarck.
Yep.
They say they interfered with the receiver.
Held him, yeah.
Flag down, and that is going to be holding against Lamarck. That's going to wipe out an interception.
Now, is that 10 yards from the
10 yards from the line of scrimmage, automatic first down.
So instead of having the ball first and 10 at around their 39-yard line, Lamarck is going to give Sterling 10 yards and then first down.
That ball should be marked down at around the 17.
The Cougars.
Official spot will be. You're right.
Yep.
At 17. Or actually, I'll say the 16. One.
Cougars are basically handing yardage and given the penalties. They're way on the negative side with penalties.
And movement. As one of the offensive linemen for Sterling jumped a bit quick, and see both of these teams are in desperate need to get the rust off. Actually, that's going to be a timeout. Sterling uses their second timeout of the first quarter with 2:03 to go. It is 16-8. Sterling leading Lamarck to go first quarter.
Right,
first and 10 for Sterling at the Lamarck 16-yard line. Big pass play of 34 yards and a penalty by the Cougars have set Sterling in good field position. Weathers back, has pressure, will take off, has room to run. He'll go inside the 10 and he'll step up out of bounds.
Oh, there's going to be a flag.
And flags flying everywhere, a little too exuberant. And he'll put it half the distance to the goal.
All right, this young Lamarck team, both offense and defense, is going to have to grow up in this ball game here. Or they're going to find themselves on the short end of the opening of the season.
And right now, Sterling already up by eight, knocking on the door to regain a two-score lead. So he was pushed out of bounds at around the seven-yard line. So he was about a yard short of the first before the personal foul penalty came in. Wait and see what the call will be. Are they going to wave it off or what? Nope. Personal foul. Whoa.
We got a holding against offense here. So what do we do with the out of bounds? There was a flag, a late hit.
Yep, dead ball.
It's all set.
Okay, here it is. Okay, so they're going to move it back to the spot. It's a redo.
Nope.
No, basically you're going to end up taking up 5 yards.
It's going to be a plus 5 yards.
Plus five, okay. That's right, because you got 15 on the flagrant.
So at the end of the day, 5 yards are gained. They'll put the ball at the 8-yard line up Lamarck with 1 minute, 55 seconds to go in the first quarter. I'll wait and see, get the officials straightened out.
Trying to figure out where the ball needs to go?
Yep. Looks like nope. Yep.
It's going to be a first down.
Okay, it's automatic.
So it is, it's an automatic first.
That's right.
So first down at the 13-yard line. And it'll be a play to Hall, and he is going to carry a few defenders with them down to around the 9-yard line. So
Jalen Walker.
So pick up of about four on that play. See if we can get the rest of these guys in. Number five is going to be Shannon James at one of your defensive spots in the secondary. Number two, Jerron Freeman.
18.
Number 18, that will be Jalen Walker.
44.
44, that will be Jamie Brooks. Second and six. Weathers felt the pressure, and he will go down.
Called the blitz.
Waited too long. They brought the house in. The aforementioned Jamie Brooks is going to get his first sack as a varsity player.
Perfectly timed call for the blitz.
And over the years, haven't we seen that number just a few times?
Just
before?
A few times. That number 44 has looked very outstanding on the defensive side of things for the Cougars.
Brings up a third and 11 now, guys.
Yes. We'll put the ball at the 15-yard line. Weathers back, tries to swing past to Hall, and Hall's not going to get much of anything as he is going to be brought down at around the 9-yard line, so he'll be short up the first down.
He was looking for Evans. Fourth down.
Well, with them going for two,
yep,
2 points on the conversion, I suspect they do not have a kicker.
No.
So I don't look for any field goals
I don't think you're going to see a field goal specialist coming in with these guys. So fourth down, they are going to simply go after it.
Big defensive stand right here
would
be good.
Yep, it'll be a huge boost of confidence for this team across the board if you can get that. 7 seconds on the play clock. Need to hurry up and get that one off unless you want to blow their final timeout to
they might
one.
Not make
he
it.
Didn't make it. Oh, they just did, but they are fresh out of timeout with 45 seconds to go in the first quarter. We'll take the commercial break. It is Sterling leading Lamarck by a count of 16-7. Coug Sports Net will be right
fourth
back.
Fourth
down coming up for Sterling.
Big fourth down here in this first quarter.
Need to get the ball to around the 3-yard line. So call it fourth and six. Evans is now making it empty and able to swing the ball up in the air, and that is going to be a touchdown.
No,
incomplete.
Came down out of bounds.
Came down out of bounds when it looked. He had reset, he had the catch, but did not pay attention to where he was, and that's a missed opportunity there for Sterling.
Turnover on down, guys.
And it just as easily could have been a push-off, too, for that offensive man, because as he pushed the defender in the back, we're trying to gain a little bit of separation there.
With 39 seconds to go. Lamarck will have the ball now at their own 9-yard line.
Lewis, I think that's a referee concentrating more on the ball and the feet than he was on the defender. So
yeah, you're right.
I think we got away with one.
Lonnie's led a scoring drive his last time on the field. See if he can make it two in a row. And it'll be a handoff to Guidry, and Guidry is going to be stopped immediately. Swarming him down, they are committed to shutting him down, and for the most part, they've held their own. Number 24 in there for the Raiders. Do not have a jersey number on him. See if we can rectify that. 19 and 18 seconds counting. We'll see if the Cougars can run one more play here in the first quarter. And movement on Sterling.
But I don't see a flag.
Nope, no flag. They're just going to let that one go. They're just going to let the quarter run down.
Okay.
Just about the ball, you'll end up getting about four, maybe five on that play. So the end of the first quarter, a very uneven quarter to begin with for Lamarck. But the scoring run by Lanius and a defensive stop by the defense has allowed the Cougars to get out of here trailing 16-8 after one quarter of play.
Brandon Williams, Sports Net, will be right back.
Lewis Perrin Jr. along with senior stats down on the sidelines, on the field in the stands right now, started the second quarter. It is 16-8, Sterling leading Lamarck, but the Cougars facing a third down, and it will be Preston trying to get close to the first down. She is slammed out of bounds.
He's picked that one up with about 3 or 4 yards to spare.
Did he got that one? Number 23 there on the stop.
His second effort, he saw that the hole closing on the inside falling behind his blocker, and that quickness of that lateral movement is what got him that first down.
Explosive sophomore, they want to find ways to get him involved, and thus far they're doing a good job of keeping him involved. So first and 10 at the 22-yard line. And it'll be Guidry, and Guidry's going to break a couple of tackles down to around the 26-yard line. Looked like he could have got a lot more, but give credit to the Sterling defense as they were holding on to dear life, keeping him from trying to hit the corner.
Did you see him push his blocker ahead?
Yeah.
He said, go on, get going, guy. I'm right behind you.
Good run nonetheless. He picks up 5 on that play, so make it second down and 5. I'll say second down and six at the 27-yard line. Longius under the center. Man in motion, and it will be Preston. Preston turns the corner, has 35, has 40,
speed.
And it'll go out of bounds at around the 43-yard line. So a pickup of 16 on that play.
That's a bread and butter play so far tonight, guys.
They have not been able to solve it, and when you've got a guy like Perry Preston with his speed and athleticism, that's a play that's going to go gangbusters most of the night.
Yeah, he's turning the corner before the linebacker's got an angle on him.
Yep, that lightning to Guidry's thunder going up the middle. These defenders are having to wait and watch to see who has that ball to know how to react.
First and 10 at the 43-yard line. Your man in motion will hand up to Guidry, tries to turn the corner, does, has midfield, has 45, has 40, down to around the 33-yard line, and that's DeMarco Guidry. The power and speed were on display with that run. That ball goes down to the 34-yard line.
23 yards?
Yes, 23 yards on the carry. 23 yards for Guidry.
Guidry coming back over here, getting a little bit more oxygen. It's early in the season. These guys hadn't quite got there in the groove.
First and 10, they'll hand it off to Preston. Preston has blockers, turns the corner on his feet, out of bounds to around inside the 20, looks like. It will be around the 19-yard line.
Preston on the carry.
So if that's the case, that's a first down, and the Cougars are back in the red zone.
He picked up his own 18-yard gain on that play.
18 yards on the carry for Preston. Spot the ball at the 15-yard line. 10:44 to go, first half. Cougs trailing by 8, and it'll be a handoff. Looks like they were all on top of that one.
That inside handoff, the inside running game, guys, is not quite there tonight. It's clear that Lamarck has got superior speed to the outside, but when they keep trying to soften up that defense on the inside, they hadn't quite got it together.
They have not been able to solve number 54, Ja'Cory White, who has been very active thus far in this contest. They'll give Preston a breather. It will replace him with number 5, Shannon James. We saw him a few times last season in the backfield.
man in motion movement, and you can go ahead and see the hankies fly on that one.
Looks like that Lonnie's was calling for the ball, and the center just didn't deliver.
So loss of five will make it second down and 16.
So that nice momentum, long drive started down at our own 9-yard line.
Yep, and that momentum slowed down just a bit. Second and 16 now at the 21-yard line.
Might add that 9-yard start was after a fourth down stand by the Cougars. Took over on downs.
Second down, 16 to go at the 21-yard line. Man in motion, it'll be play action. Lonius rolls out, looking, it'll be sacked. Had a man open but couldn't release the ball because number two, Frank Brown, coming in on a blitz, able to drag him down and record the sack. And that's a huge loss of yardage that will push the Cougars back to the 31-yard line. So a loss of 10 on that play is going to make it third down and now 45 to go.
Number 7, Miles Lonnie, is dropped in the backfield. Brings up third and long for the Cougars.
Third down and 26 if you need it. And you'll have to get the ball to the 5-yard line. Lonnie is followed the snap, steps up, and that ball's incomplete, and that was dangerously close to being intercepted. Ja'Cory Wright read the play perfectly and was not able to reel the ball in.
Melonius actually really didn't do too bad of a job there whenever he realized that that Preston was covered very, very well over there and just threw the ball down at his feet.
Yeah, you know, it's a smart play. It's a smart play, but the promising drive with a penalty and a sack conspiring to push the Cougars from the 15-yard line up Sterling back to the 31, so they will go ahead and punt.
Well, at least they're going to set up that way anyway.
Oh, we'll probably see if they'll try to play the possession game.
Yeah, pin them back maybe with inside their 10, if hopefully.
Marker will just pooch it. Maybe a fair catch.
Oh, yeah. That could have maybe possibly rolled into the end zone.
Yeah, I think I left that one alone.
24 yards on the punt, but still good spot for the Cougar defense to start as the Raiders will have their worst field position of the evening thus far, as they will be at their own 7-yard line with 8 minutes, 59 seconds to go first half. Still in possession of a 16-8 lead.
Now that drive didn't end exactly the way that we wanted it to, but the positive there was some good ball control as that drive went 10 plays, started at the 9-yard line, got all the way down inside the 20 before penalties and sacks just put them back far enough to where they needed to do that punt.
Weathers will give the ball to Brown.
That's a big old running back.
Evans is going to lumber his way forward. 5'9", 225. Ran for nearly 500 yards last season.
Jaden Bishop had to step up in a hurry in order to drag him down before he was like almost the last man.
He was starting to look like he was getting some momentum. He will barrel his way for a gain of 8. Second down and 2 at the 15, and then we'll go with Evans. And Evans tries to turn the corner, and that is going to be
good pursuit.
A failure for him as he was dogged by a host of Cougars.
Desmond Murray first on him that time and just kept him going laterally until a couple more Cougars come in there and give him a hand.
Derek Middleton, number 24, also in there on the stop. So a loss of 1 for Evans will make it third down and 2.
8 minutes in this second quarter.
Third down and 3 for the Raiders.
Sterling nursing a 16-8 lead.
Third and 3 at the 14-yard line. 7:49 to go first half, and Sterling will spread things out. Evans in the backfield with Weathers. And we'll bring out 4 wide receivers. Weathers drops back, steps up. He's just going to heat this thing up, and that's a wobbler that's going to fall well short of his intended target.
Yeah, closest man there actually was a Cougar, number 2, Was it Jerron Freeman?
This we could get some good field position out of these guys. With fourth down and ball inside the 20, I can't imagine them trying to go for it.
Well, it looks like Weathers will be handling the punting. It'll be Perry Preston will be returning the punt.
That's a good man to have back there returning a punt.
Along with number
this
six,
is their
Lamont.
First punt tonight, isn't it, Sterling?
Yeah.
It is.
This is Sterling's first punt.
We've got two guys back there. Lamont's number six is lined up around the 45 of Sterling. You have Perry Preston hovering around, and a flag is down. And it looks like it's going to be a delay of game.
We'll take that 5 more yards.
That's going to hurt.
Delay of game, and that will push them back 5.
Or do we got a timeout going on here?
Is it a timeout?
Nope, it's delay.
I guess no. He just called his team over to the sideline right quick. Or did he?
No, it's a timeout.
Okay, that's what I thought.
We'll
take
ahead
it with
and
him.
Take it. Cougs Sports Net will
so
be right back.
It was a delay of game after all, and it'll be Weathers back deep to punt.
He'll get it off. It's a line drive that the Cougars will not touch. They're going to get great field position out this evening way as the ball will roll down at the 48-yard line. So a 39-yard punt for Weathers as the Cougars will get the ball back first and 10 at the 48 up Sterling with 7:24 to go in the first half.
Lamarck begins first and 10 from the 48.
Let there be lights.
I like it.
Yes. First and 10, the 48-yard line. 7 minutes, 24 seconds to go.
Really, Lamarck has put together two good drives on these previous two possessions. Let's see if they continue in here and put 6 more on the board.
It'll be Bishop going in motion. It'll be a handoff to Guidry, and Guidry's going to plow his way past a couple of defenders, and he'll get down to around the 43-yard line.
He actually bowled over that
he
defender.
He did. That's number 6, David Burton. He left his calling card at the end as that stung Burton just a bit.
He did. The way he got up, you could tell he was stunned.
Gain of 5 on the play brings up 2nd and 5.
Second and 5 for Lamarck.
And that was just actually the 3rd and 4th man that touched him to bring him down.
Just inside, 7 minutes to go, first half. It'll be Guidry turning the corner, has the 40, 35. All jackknifed his way to around the 30. We'll spot him at the 30-yard line. So Guidry, a gain of 13 on that play.
Just his body language, Brandon, you mentioned it. He runs angry. Just when he gets up after being tackled, he's still got that mentality about him.
And he got a little bit of lightning in him, too, as that was a nice run around that edge.
He averaged 11 yards per carry last season. We'll remember the game against Caldwell in the area round.
Oh, the
and
ball's
that
on the
ball
ground.
Is on the
that
ground.
Ball was set down. Yep. No.
They're going to say, no, they're going to say Sterling ball.
He put that ball on the ground.
I thought he was down before the ball hit the ground anyway. Ah.
Careless handling by the Cougars. As the Raiders will get the ball back at the 30-yard line with 6:33 to go, first half.
Lamarck is moving the ball the last 3 possessions, but turnovers twice now with the fumble, the interception, and penalties has been biting them and keeping them from being just a consistent offense. They churn up good yardage, and all of a sudden something bites them. They'll shoot themselves in the foot.
That is not what you need. So Sterling will get the ball back. 6:33 to go here in the first half. 1st and 10 for them at the 31-yard line officially. So not only does Guidry lose a yard, but he also loses the football as well. So 1st and 10 coming up. Shotgun set, 2 backs in. It'll be a handoff to Brown, and Brown is going to work his way to around the 35-yard line. So a gain of about 4 on the carry. Oh, Raiders, you're right, Mike. They have not been exceptionally well, with the exception of a couple of big plays in the passing game. But Lamarck has just killed themselves with penalties
and turnovers.
And turnovers.
3 yards officially on the run, so second down and 7 will be a hand up to Evans, and Evans will break a couple of tackles and will work his way close to the first down. He got to about the 40-yard line
Clifton Evans on the
before
carry.
He was finally dragged down by Marlon Ford, number 99, and also number 10, Cordell Stewart. But it's a gain of 6. He's going to make it 3rd down and 1.
He came close to being stripped as he was coming through that line.
Yeah, that was Stewart that just grabbed onto him and hung on. Actually went for a little bit of a ride.
So 3rd and 1. They'll go gun movement that they did not call.
No, they got back. No contact.
Others bring that clock down. He'll drop back. Has the rush, tries to turn the corner. He's just going to throw this one away.
Brings up 4th and 1, guys.
Lots of pressure there by the Cougars. That was number 24, Derek Middleton.
That pass was closer to our mascot than it was to any receiver.
And Brandon, you just said a key sentence. Pressure on the quarterback. That right there has been the difference in him being able to launch those long, just Hail Mary passes. Putting pressure on him, he can't sit there and try to find a receiver.
They're lining up the punt. You'll have Preston lined up for the Cougars at around his own 35-yard line.
And he's going to punt.
He will. And he gets off a nice punt. Nice hang time. It won't get much of a favorable bounce, but it's going to be down at the 30-yard line.
So the fumble didn't hurt him.
Fumble did not hurt as all as the defense stiffened up.
But we lost field position.
Yep, 30-yard punt. As Lamarck will get the ball back with 4:58 to go here in the first half.
All right, we got 4 minutes and 50 seconds to be able to mount a drive to be able to tie this up right before the closing seconds of the half.
Just got to be consistent with the ball. Offset eye formation, twins to the far side, Preston in the backfield with Lonius under center. The man in motion will be Evans, and it's going to be Preston trying to turn the corner, and he is going to be stopped finally as number 4, Rashard Johnson, grabbed a hold of him and resisted numerous attempts by Perry to try to get loose. Finally got some help from his teammates. But that is going to be a loss of yardage.
Yeah, just only about one.
A loss of 1 on the play.
I thought he had more yardage, guys. Boy, but the defender just was able to latch on to him.
So it doesn't look as bad as it might have appeared. And 2nd and 11 at the 30, at the 29-yard line for Lamar. Handoff is going to be to Preston, and Preston's got Romo cut back, still on his feet, gets the ball to around the 43-yard line, so a 14-yard run by Perry. He makes up for that previous play in a big way. He gets the ball to the 43, pick up a 14 on the play.
First down.
4 minutes to go here in the first half.
Plenty of time.
Preston will get a breather as they'll put Shannon James back into the contest.
Who's number 9?
Number 9 for Lamarck. That is going
Saldana.
To be Saldana. And it's going to be a timeout by the Cougars. 3:45 to go first half. Let's take the timeout with them at Sterling 16. Lamarck 8. Cougar Sports Network. After the Lamarck timeout, it's going to be 1st down and 10 at the 43-yard line. 3:45 to go first half. Cougars have moved the ball up and down the field, but 2 turnovers and a host of penalties have really kept them from cutting into the 16-8 deficit. They'll go offset eye down with Shannon James in the backfield. Evans is the fullback. Lonnie is awaiting the snap as he will get ready to change plays.
Well, they got 8 men in the box, guys.
They are daring the Cougars to pass at
this
point.
They're right in the box.
It'll be a handoff to James, and James tries to turn a corner. And he's going to spin off the one defender, spins off another one, and he turned that into a nice run. Never gave up on it and got about 4, maybe 5 on that play.
He's a lot stronger than he looks, guys.
Got the ball to the 49-yard line, so that was a gain of 6.
Yep.
Gain of 7 brings up 2nd down.
2nd down and 4 for the Cougars at the 49-yard line. 2:55 to go here in the first half. will be able to fullback. Ball is lost, and Sterling will get the ball right back. Poor centers exchange, and the Raiders get the ball right back. Number 71, that's going to be Chris Whitehead with the recovery. And Sterling gets the ball in Lamar territory at the 46-yard line.
Is that third turnover?
Yep. First half alone.
Third miscue of the evening. And like I said, it's just been a continuing theme here in the first half. Cougars show promise, but miscues just continue to shoot, allow them to shoot themselves in the foot.
Defense is going to step up again.
They've been up to the task for the most part. And it'll be Weathers trying to cause all over, and that ball is loose. And the Cougars look like they may have got it. Still a scrum. Still waiting for some kind of confirmation. Weathers just had that ball pop out of his
hands. There we go. There's your confirmation. Lamarck ball.
Cougars will get the ball back.
Number 99.
And it is going
Marlon Ford.
Isn't that number
Ford?
It wasn't four. Looks like 32. 52 is the guy down there.
Okay, all right.
Number 52, that's going to be Keyshawn Holmes, who's the man who ends up with the ball. So Weathers tried to roll out, lost the ball.
It's still a bunch of time. Oh, and he's 37
time.
Seconds.
Yeah, when he signs the ball on the sideline, you know he recovered it.
So first and 10 for the Cougars. We'll go shotgun with 2:37 to go here in the first half.
Delayed
handoff to Preston to the 40, 45 midfield. Tries to find a block. He'll go out of bounds at around the 45-yard line.
And that was number four taking down number four, but not until he gained what?
Preston looks like a gain of 18.
Yep.
To the 45 inside of Sterling's territory.
44. Gain. We'll see 44.
Uh-oh, somebody down. He's cramping up.
Yep, Perry Preston. Yeah, and you normally see it this time of year.
He's cramping
that
up.
That heat plays a factor. You've got a guy cramping up.
Let's call a timeout,
Brandon.
We'll
go ahead and do it. 2:30 to go first half. Perry Preston coming back off the field under his own power. Cramped up. He'll come back. Almost need a little time to get the kinks out. But it's his 19-yard run as the Cougars back in business, back in Sterling territory.
2 minutes, 30 seconds to go in this first half.
Shannon James came in for Perry there. Give him a little bit of a breather.
Shotgun set, four wide, with James in the backfield. It'll be a handoff to James, and James is going to be stuffed. They read it perfectly.
Now, Sterling has made a habit of being able to reach back there and grab those jerseys and then just be able to hang on.
Yeah, that play's developing a little too slow, or else the Shannon offensive James line is not holding their blocks long enough.
They're smelling it out because they're basically daring the Cougars to throw the ball, which is why you're seeing as many as eight guys in the box.
And we're going to have to throw the ball if we're going to break them out of that. At least give it a try.
Ball spotted at the 46-yard line, make it second and 12. It'll be a handoff to James. He'll get yardage to around the 40-yard line.
Jackson's still got two timeouts in his pocket, doesn't he?
He does. He got six, so five of that actually, so make it third down and seven. Third and seven at the 41-yard line. 1:35 and counting. Lanius drops back, rolls out, looking, tries to run, and he's going to be stopped at the line of scrimmage as good coverage by the Raiders kept Lanius from being able to go downfield. So it'll be a fourth down coming up. Lanius took a shot, and looks like he will still keep going. Wait and see what they will do here. Looks like they will punt.
57 seconds inside a minute. The way the defense has been playing, I think I'd have probably gone for this one. But
wait to see what Jackson has. The punting unit.
He's on a call timeout.
Yep.
He's on. Go ahead and run it down.
43, 42. Let's go ahead and take the timeout. 41 seconds to go in the first half. It is Sterling 16, Lamarck 8. Coug Sports Net will be
40
right back.
Seconds to go in the first half. Cougars have the punt team out.
number 18. Sterling, Jalen Walker.
Sterling's acting like they're not quite sure if they believe this or not.
Not going to quite buy it. Walker will get it off. It's a high punt that will get a nice LaMarc bounce that will be downed inside the five. They'll down it at the three.
There we go. Good punt.
39-yard punt. We'll put the ball at the three-yard line with 30 seconds to go.
I don't know if they're either going to try a Hail Mary, see what happens, see if they can pick up either a catch
surprised.
Or either that or defensive
Raiders
penalty.
First and 10
would not be surprised if they do. Sterling is coached by former Colorado All Big Eight defender and former New York Giants defensive end Kenavis McGee. McGee is part of 1990 national champ. I should say co-national championship. Sorry, Georgia Tech. Co-national championship team.
Yeah, that's just going to be a straight kneel down.
Yep. He's going to let the clock
And LaMarc's got one timeout, I think. Well, no, they're showing we have none. How in the world did Sterling call timeout twice and they're still showing two on the board?
Well, it looks like they're just going to be content to just go into the locker room. 13 seconds and counting.
So all the scoring was in the first quarter.
Yep. Cougs had opportunities in the second. We're not able to push it in, but the defense has definitely stepped up since the early mistake. So 24 minutes are in the books. It is LaMarc trailing Sterling by a count of 16-8. Coug Sports Network will be right back. Enjoy the halftime.
Mike Lockwood, Lewis Perrin Jr., and of course in the stands, Senior Stacks.
Start of the second half coming up in Sterling 16, LaMarc 7. After the early touchdown on Sterling's opening drive, the Black Flag defense is what they're being called this season. They have really held their own against Sterling, but the offense, which has put up 188 yards, Lewis, has just been hampered by turnovers and mental errors.
Penalties have bitten them big time. There's been seven penalties for a total of 40 yards. It could have been worse. One of those penalties was offset by a 15-yard personal foul. So it has not been pretty. Turnovers, you don't win the turnover battle, you're going to be hard-pressed to win a lot of games. And right now, they're down 3-1 in this game.
Well, you look at the numbers on the surface, you'd think that this is an efficient game for the Cougars. Perry Preston, 10 carries, 107 yards. DeMarco Guidry, 14 carries, 86 yards. But the Cougars have not generated a single yard passing in the first half. In fact, they've only attempted two passes. And of course, one of those was intercepted for a touchdown. You look at the fact that, again, three turnovers, two fumbles, and that pick six have really kept LaMarc from getting back into this contest. And when you look, have a team such as Sterling that lives and dies on that home run ball, you can't afford to give them an opportunity to blow this game open.
You know, guys, they actually had, LaMarc had a second turnover taken away from Sterling where they intercepted the ball, was running upfield, but pass interference gave that ball back to Sterling. So on the short end of the stick again when in that turnover ratio.
That's it. And you know, like you said, the defense is doing what it's supposed to be doing. We're just going to have to get this offense clicking a little bit better, and they're going to have to open it up just a little bit, as we've consistently seen Sterling putting eight men in the box and daring LaMarc to pass.
Pedro Rubio's kick is going to be to the far side. We're going to see who's has the football,
and
whoever
swarmed.
It was got
wow.
swarmed.
He never got going.
That was number two, Frank Brown. Tried to get around the corner, but failed to do so, and the Raiders will start the second half.
He didn't even make the 20-yard line.
Yeah. No, not at all.
Yeah, he was going all laterally, hoping that maybe some hole would open up, and it just never did, as LaMarc's defense and special teams, both in the punting game and in the coverage game, have done a real nice job tonight.
First and 10 for the Raiders. Ball at their own 18-yard line as we start the second half. Darius Weathers is at quarterback for the Raiders. With Evans, number 44, in the backfield, and that's going to get the first carry, and Evans is going to break a couple of tackles, and is going to pull his way forward. That ball darn near popped loose, but his strong hands kept that from happening. But nonetheless, Evans with a bruising run
Looks like he'll get about 8 on that carry, so make it 2nd down and 2.
That handoff was just a little bit enough of a delay that opened up some holes in that offensive line, but the linebackers from Lamarck stepped up pretty fairly quickly, able to shut him down after a 7-yard gain. But there was a massive hole that he did run through to get into that secondary.
Not a burner by any stretch of the imagination, but at 5'9", 225, Evans is a very difficult man to bring down. They'll bring a 4 wide receiver set out shotgun. They'll bring Brown over into a slot to the near right. High snap again will be Evans, and Evans is going to pull his way and take about 4 defenders with him past the 30 to around the 33-yard line.
Weathers is showing just enough of that drop back. He's taking those couple of steps back before handing off, getting some of these offensive linemen for Lamarck to bite. Defensive lineman for Lamarck to bite, like perhaps maybe we're doing a little of a play action, and that man's being able to run by him to get into the secondary.
4-man front for the Cougars on 1st and 10 at the 33. He'll swing the ball out. Ball is going to be caught by Brown, and Brown lost the ball, but fortunately it's going to end up into one of the Sterling offensive players. Ball popped loose as he probably got about 1 yard. But that fumble actually works in their favor. They ended up getting a couple extra yards out of it.
Lamarck, I like their tackling style. Guys, they're going low. They're not trying to tackle high. So far, their tackling technique in this game is looking pretty good.
They get 2nd down and about 6, and Evans again grinding forward, as he will get close to a 1st down.
They're going to want to try to churn out the clock, guys, I do believe, with an 8-point lead.
Yeah, they're definitely going to want to keep the ball away from Lamarck.
Yeah.
Lamarck has shown they can move it when they have it if they can simply avoid the mistakes.
Yeah, did we mention the yardage? Did we have the yardage on Sterling as far as what their offense
Sterling up? Has 136
okay.
in the 1st half. Most
and
of that,
51.
103 of those come via the passing.
Yeah.
3rd down and 1 at the 41-yard line. Cougs need to stop here to get the ball back to the offense. Hand off to Evans, and Evans is going to get
Yeah, they got him about 1 foot short, it looks like, guys.
We'll see with a measurement. We'll have to bring out the chain gang on that one. Good
stop. Will or not. Bring the ball all the way. This I simply don't understand. The play happened at the middle of the field. They pull the ball all the way up to the other side, and then
that?
Yeah, that's not good technique.
It's obvious. They want to get the chain gang exercise.
That's not making sense, guys.
No, that's a new.
Why do you bring it away from the hash mark? That is just bizarre. I've never seen this before.
I haven't either.
Well, you know,
I mean, that.
And it was the head official that actually brought the ball out.
Oh, he is short by
a yard.
By a yard. He got nothing on that one.
But I'm still very.
and now they're going to mark. The
yeah.
You know, this is like.
I mean, that's why you have the hash marks, guys.
There's an old Aggie adage, that says, you know, mark with the micrometer or measure with the micrometer, mark with chalk, and cut with the chainsaw. Well, that's kind of like what we saw going on here.
Tell you what, because Sterling could actually complain, because I'm thinking it was closer than that when it was out there to where the tackle was.
I did as well.
He's definitely voicing his disapproval. With good reason.
Yeah, he's asking, why did you guys have to go all the way across? You know, you're 20 plus yards away from where the ball was brought down to measure.
Yeah, it looks like they're going to bring the punting unit on.
Well, they're going to bring the chain back out again.
Once again, well, just to prove you wrong. Let's see.
It's not like you can remark.
Yeah, this is just.
It was an approximation the first time, guys.
Yep, he is still short of a 1st down.
Now what? Now you're gonna put it in the middle of the field?
He's still short.
Yep. No matter how you look at it, he's short.
I tell you what, it took 5 minutes to do that measurement, guys.
Oh, my gosh.
And they are set up for a punt. I'd be careful in this one.
I would be, too. They've had a couple of fourth and ones where they just chose the punt. It'll be dangerous to see what they do. Here he is back. And Weathers gets off a fairly good punt.
He's done this a couple times now.
Gets a bit of a, had a bit of a bounce before it hit the defender, hit one of the up guys.
Well, that was
a 26-yard line.
An interesting drive and an interesting marking by the official.
35-yard punt officially. Put the ball at the 26-yard line.
All right, let's get that offense churning. I mean, you put up, what, 200-plus yards, correct?
Or 188. Right?
188. Okay, that's a good half, though.
188, all on the ground. You got to see if we can open this thing up a bit. Perry in motion. Has room, 35-40. You know, be pushed out of bounds at around the 42-yard line.
So a bit of a late hit.
16-yard gain. For Perry, who is already over 100 yards, that's going to make it 123 for him on just 11 carries.
That's been a very good play. Each time he's run it, he's picked up a good 10-plus every time, guys.
First and 10 at the 42-yard line for the Cougars.
Yeah, both running backs, Skidry and Perry, have had better luck whenever they go slightly to the outside.
No, taking advantage of the play from their tackles. Perry again will get the carry and carry, you know, turn the corner. Gets to around the 49-yard line. So he'll pick up 7 on that play.
Preston on the carry. Showing good eyes. He knows when to make the cut. He's pretty instinctual in knowing that he's not going to get outside that last back and making a cut up on the inside when he sees that that outside lane's not going to be open for him.
If he can avoid the injury bug, this is a kid who can be a very special ball player. Second down, only a handoff to Guidry, and Guidry's going to slash and break the tackle, turns the corner, breaks another tackle. Guidry still running. People, that is why they say he runs angry.
26 yards.
If that doesn't wake you up, nothing will. DeMarco Guidry felt that, hey, this crowd's been a little too tepid, so let me just hammer a couple of defenders, carry a couple with me, and get 23 yards and move the chains.
Good-looking athlete, guys.
That's going to put him over 100 tonight. First and 10.
Bringing in James into the backfield
at
now.
At the 28-yard line. James.
Hang on to that ball.
Yeah, that was a little dicey.
Yeah, that looked a little scary for a moment. The ball was shaking in and out of his hands before he finally got control of it. Jacoby Foe, number 22, number 52, Quentin White there on the stop. We'll get about 2 on that carry. So make it second down and 8. With 7:27 to go here in the third quarter. Sterling leading 16-8. Cougars driving, trying to get in position for a tie.
Lonnie's going to step back, see what the coach is calling him.
He have got that box stacked. Evans tried the lead block, but they knew what was coming. You've got 9 guys in the box. They're just basically saying, please throw the football. They're daring the Cougars to throw the ball on them at this point.
I think maybe they got just a little bit of a bug. That early interception just kind of like scared them a little bit, I think. And they're going to have to open it up a little bit. Maybe
at
just the short pass.
I mean, those linebackers are within 5 yards of the line of scrimmage, guys.
Third down. 7 at the 25, and it will be Perry. They knew what was coming, and when you have that kind of situation where there is no respect for the pass, those things will happen. They sat on that sweep. They were able to bring him down, and again, number 52, if you're looking for a player of the game for Sterling, I'm going to say number 52, Quentin White, would be my choice.
We're getting ready to call a timeout,
yeah, looks
I
like
believe.
We got an injury timeout. Somebody's cramped up on the Sterling side. We'll take it. 6-18 to go, third quarter. Cougs Sports Net will be right back.
For Sterling, Clifton Evans.
been solid as a running back, also been solid at linebacker. He cramped up a bit, was able to walk off the field under his own power. So fourth down and 9 coming up for the Cougars at the 27-yard line. 6 minutes, 12 seconds to go. Lonius drops back, steps up, throws. Ball's going to be caught by Stewart, and Stewart's got the 20 to the 15. And that is going to be his first completion as a Cougar, and that's going to move the chains. And Lonius hobbling a little bit as he will hobble to the huddle. It'll be a completion. It'll get the ball down to the 16-yard line. So a gain of 11 on that play on a 4th and 9.
Twisted his ankle, guys, looks like.
I wasn't sure whether it was that or whether it was a cramp.
Looked like somebody stepped on his foot. We're in shotgun, 1st and 10 at the 16-yard line. Still in the game. He'll drop back, goes counterplay. It'll be Perry. Well, he pressed it, and he cramped
up before he
went out of bounds.
Oh, that hurts. Oh,
indeed. Yeah, you can tell
you
the cramped up. Yeah.
Holy
he is
Michael.
Cramped up pretty bad, but not before he got 9 on that carry.
Boy, he was halfway through his run. And boy,
had
his
he thing. Been a cramps be darned, had he turned the corner, he might have scored.
Yeah, he pulled up halfway through his run, guys.
Yep.
Let's call a quick timeout.
Go ahead and do it. Coop Sports Debt will be right
second
back.
Down
and 1 coming up for Lamarck. Did continue to work on Perry on the sidelines.
Looked like Lonnie is back. He might have had a little bit, like you say, either
looked
tweaked
like
his ankle or, yeah.
Looked like somebody might have stepped on him.
They're still working on Perry over here off the sidelines.
Yep.
I wonder if they're going to allow it to continue play.
Yeah, he's walking his way toward the sidelines.
Boy, he pulled up. I mean, you could just, it was like somebody stuck a 2x4 and wrapped around his leg.
Mm-hmm, with a nail in it.
All right, ball control, boys.
2nd down, 1 yard to go. Evans is your fullback with Guidry in the backfield. Guidry breaks a tackle, turns it down.
No, that's
the
ground.
That's a ground.
That's
a
ground.
They're calling it immediately.
Yep.
They're calling
that's
it immediately.
A ground. They better.
Yep, he is down
he got
to around the 1 yard line.
I think he got robbed on that first one in the first half, but.
Yeah, I do too. I thought he put that ball, hand on the ball, put it down on the ground. But they did call it a fumble. And
all right, we got 1st and goal from the 2.
Yep. 1st and goal at the 2.
We got 5 minutes go here in this 3rd quarter. Lamarck could essentially tie it up here.
They are definitely in position to do so. 3rd time inside the red zone. Gidry's going to bash his way
Let
in
me
for
have
a
that
touchdown.
5, guys. Yes, sir.
Cash it in, cha-ching.
I like hearing that.
Guidry from 5 yards out will make it 16-14 with 4:53 to go in the 3rd. Cougs will go for 2. See Allen Franklin.
And look at Guidry here on the sidelines there. They're working on him.
Yeah, he's cramped up.
Yep.
Welcome to week 1. Cougs look like they're going to spread this one out and attempt to cut this lead. And attempt to tie this game up. Lonius under center. Lee Evans in motion on the toss sweep. And it looks like that will work. Allen Franklin with the conversion run. Shows you how deep down in the well the Cougars are at running back.
There you go. And that he made it look easy too, guys.
He did.
All right, we got a new ball game.
Indeed we do. 4 minutes, 53 seconds to go, 3rd quarter. We are knotted up at Etheridge. It is Lamarck 16, Sterling 16.
10
Cougs plays,
that will be right back.
74-yard drive highlighted again by the running of Guidry. 3 carries, 27 yards, including the 2-yard touchdown run. And Preston, 4 carries for 30 yards as the ball popped loose. Got a bit cute on the trick as Matsawa, actually his first mistake of the night is he is swarmed inside the 15.
Well, that's dangerous flipping that ball backwards like that.
The Raiders have struggled returning kicks all night long. That opening kickoff in the second half put them at the 18-yard line. They're going to start this one at the 15 with 4:45 to go here in the third.
And again, Lamarck special teams up to the challenge.
All right, we need to take control of this ball game, both sides. All right.
Four wide set. Raiders going to bring three to the far side. Weathers back, tries the quick hitter, and that should have been a loss, but that turned out to be a little bit more.
He got lucky.
Like number five, that is Terrence Brown, and Brown is the guy who had the pick six in the first quarter. Man is down for Lamarck. Marlon Ford. It looks like he's cramping up. We'll take the break. Sports Net will be right back.
Under his own power, as again, cramps really getting both teams.
Second and five, handoff will be to Evans, and Evans is going to bull his way to a first down as he will get to around a 30-yard line. Needed five, got nine.
Norlin Saldana that time in on that stop. That's a big boy sitting down.
And he's down again. Each second time he's down, looks like cramps got him. We'll take another break. Cougs Sports Net will be right
Evans
back. Able to walk off the field under his own power. Looks like he got stung on the knee. Weathers drops back, steps up, looks, goes long, has a man downfield. That ball is going to be caught. That's going to be a lot more as number 10, Bobby Davis, with the big catch, took advantage, had a huge size advantage on Richard White. And that play is going to put the Raiders down to the 25-yard line.
That's their MO tonight, Brandon.
45-yard gain on that play.
I mean, they got almost 100 yards in passing in two plays.
And that spell, like I said, they are living and dying on it. Davis' second big catch tonight for him. We'll see as we'll be a quick hitter, and that's not going to fool the Cougars. Bishop was the first man on the scene to bring him down. Also got a bit of assistance from number 14, Joel Sumlin. So Brown stiff, maybe a yard. Actually, they're going to say he lost.
No gain,
no gain
anyway.
Officially.
Yep.
So it's second and 10 at the 25-yard line with 3:04 to go here in the third quarter. We'll break out four wide receiver set and bring Trips over to the far side. Brown is to the near. With Bet they'll try to take a shot at him isolated. Cougars bring pressure. Weathers trying to run away and won't.
Huge
sack. Sherry Evans with the sack. You saw the floodgates coming when the ball was snapped, and Weathers had no chance of getting out of there. And that's a huge loss, guys. The loss of 12. We'll make it third down and 22 with 2:27 left to go in the third quarter.
Boy, that's a big play up to this point in this ball game, guys.
Second sack of the night for the Cougs.
Yeah, with that big running back out, you've pretty well limited your options of going to the pass. So that was a good call from defensive coordinator.
Indeed. Yet at the same time, it opens the door for that home run ball that the Raiders thrive on.
Oh, we've got a big time hold.
The throw. He's just going to throw a wobbler in the air, and that ball is going to be intercepted by Alan Franklin. Franklin still going before the Turf Monster brings him down at around the 23-yard line. He had room in the developing convoy, but the Cougars get the defensive stop.
He held up for cramps, too.
He did, and Franklin goes down. We'll see if he will get up. Nope, it's probably going to need some assistance. We'll take the break. 1:49 to go, third quarter. Tied at 16 here at Etheridge.
So
Cougar Sports Net will be right back.
There's all power. Cougar get the ball back, first and 10 at the 23-yard line after the Franklin interception. 1:49 to go here in the third quarter.
Idry in the backfield, and they will go with Preston on the sweep, and Preston's got room. Preston's still moving forward. He's got enough.
Hang
got close
on to
a first
it.
Down. We'll see if the forward progress gets him, and
if
we've got,
we got
another guy going down with cramps. That is number 28. Don't have a name on him, but this kid's in a bit of pain. We'll go ahead and take the break. 1:38 to go.
third quarter. Cougs Sports Net will be right back. First and 10 for the Cougars after an 11-yard run by Perry Preston. And it's going to be Preston trying to find room, tries to reverse this field. Got a nice block from Lonius, and Preston's going to get to around the 40-yard line. Flag is down, so it looks like that will come back. Flag on the far side at around at 34, so it looks like.
Referee calling holding on the far side over there.
A hold against Lamarck.
Yeah, when we'll he reverses that field, that's normally when that happens.
Exactly. That's the eighth penalty of the night for the Cougs.
You know, they're still stacking the box, and, you know, we hit, who's that, Cordell Stewart over here?
Yes.
Yep.
You know, with that little quick pitch out, I mean, you're going to have to loosen up the defense with a little bitty short pass like that, even if they only pick up 5 yards.
Exactly. You know, that's the thing. You know, you really need to shake this thing up and get them out of the box because they are not.
I mean, we're
being intimidated by, you know,
you've got two men over here on this side and only one man covering both of them. So they're not even showing any respect to the pass.
And up is going to be to Preston, and Preston's got the corner, has first down and more, and Preston will be stopped at around the 46. So on first and 20, who needs to run? Who needs to pass? When you've got Harry Preston running at the pace he's going.
16 yards.
Oh, he got the first down. Got 21 on first and on a first and 20.
First down.
So Perry Preston is actually inching towards that 200-yard range. First and 10. We go under a minute to play here in the third quarter. It'll be a delayed handoff, and they were waiting on that one.
Boy, it was delayed too long.
That was red like a C-spot run.
Exactly. Nice stop. Number 6, David Burton, is the man who delivered the hit.
Yeah, you got number 22 and number 10 over here, guys, and one defender that's almost 8 yards off of the receivers. You can pop that out over there, have one guy block for him.
That
you
play
can pick
is
up
right
easy
there for them and see if they've got time to get run with it. 7 seconds, it looks like they're going to have him just let the clock run down. Three quarters of play are in the books here at Etheridge. A bit sloppy
like
at times, but yep, just like we started, Lewis, we are knotted up as Lamarck and Sterling will go into the fourth quarter. Tied at 16, get the fours up. Lamarck, Cougs Sports Net.
Brandon
will be
Williams,
right back.
Mike Lockwood, Lewis Perrin Jr., and of course, senior stats in the stands. So we start the fourth quarter, tied at 16, and it'll be Lonius throwing a quick hitter over to Stewart, and Stewart's got a couple of defenders as he moves forward. Ball's completed as they get to around the 49-yard line.
About a 7-yard pickup.
About a 7-yard pickup. They'll be about 4 yards short of the first down. Third down coming up. They'll move some personnel out.
I think this is 4-down territory, guys, I would think. We'll just have to see.
Ooh, I don't know. 20, as well as our defense is playing.
Number 22, one of your basketball players, Desmond Murray, is lined up deep. She's in a twin set. An offset eye formation, and they will hand the ball off, and that is Guidry. And Guidry's moving the chains and moves forward for a first down. DeMarco Guidry just batters through the Sterling defense and will be down to around the 32-yard line. So a pickup of 17.
Stiffened up again, guys.
Yep. So second down, so a first and 10 for Lamarck at the 32-yard line. 11:05 to go here in the third and the fourth quarter as the Cougars looking to get their first lead of the night.
James back in.
Been rotating running backs. We've seen Preston, Guidry, and James. We also saw Allen Franklin on that two-point conversion, which tied the score up.
Well, that the offensive line is going heavy on that left side.
They are indeed. So it'll be Preston trying to turn the corner. Does. First down and more. Nice fake as Preston will go out of bounds, but give credit to number 11, Jaden Bishop, with that block. Flag is down.
Oh, don't you tell me.
There was no holding on that. Not,
no,
well, at
it
least
can't
not
be
on
Bishop.
Block.
No, not at all.
Going backwards. Well, one thing, we've had the penalty bug all night long. We haven't cleaned that up, guys.
No, that is penalty number 10 on Lamarck. That will push them back to the 42-yard line.
Is that first and 20?
First and 20, yep. Indeed. First and 20 at the 42 up Sterling. 10:32 to go here in the fourth quarter, tied at 16 each. Lonius drops back, has pressure, it'll be sacked. That is number 8, LaQuinn Harkless, and on the sack as Lonius really had no chance as Harkless barreled in and records the sack. That's going to push the Cougars back to their 49-yard line. So that is a loss of 9 to make it second down and 29 for the Cougars at their 49-yard line. And up is going to be to Preston, and Preston gets to the 45. He'll get past the 40. He'll bull past a couple of defenders, and he will be out of bounds.
No, there's no penalty there.
No, not at all. You know, you can scream all you want, but that was clean.
Jackson just won that extra 15 yards.
Yeah.
You can't blame him for trying.
Preston was able to get a good chunk of it back on that carry. Gets the ball to around the 38-yard line, so he got 13 of those yards back. Still third down and long coming up for the Cougs.
And you're definitely in four-down territory now, especially in the fourth quarter of a tie ball game.
But at the 38-yard line, and they need to get to the 22 for a first down.
They're down to 3 seconds. They're going to have to hurry it up and get this one off.
They
and
just
they
did. Lonnie is back, zips it downfield, heaves it up, and that ball! Oh, man!
In it out of his hands.
It went out of one, out of the defender's hands and right out of the hands of Stubblefield.
I think he got he got distracted by it hitting the defender, but he could have very easily caught that ball.
Cougs missed out on that one, so fourth down and 16 coming up. See if they'll bring the punting unit on to pin them deep. And they will.
I think I might have done this as well. With as much time as we've got left on the clock.
And with the way the defense is playing, it's a smart move.
Yeah, as long as we can avoid that big play.
Walker set the punt. He will get it off. That is going to go out. Touchback. 38 on the punt. It'll end up being a gross of 18. So at 9:25 to go in the fourth quarter, Sterling gets a chance to get the ball back. Tied at 16. Raiders turned the ball over on their last opportunity.
Raiders being first and 10.
And again, a penalty and a sack is pretty much what destroyed that drive.
Exactly. And that has really been a recurring theme for Lamarck.
Especially with the penalties now. Those ten penalties for about 70 yards?
Yep, 10 for about 65 to 70 yards. Those things are starting to add up. First and 10 for the Raiders at the 20-yard line. Darius Weathers out to lead the offense. Two back set. And two wides, and it'll be a handoff to Brown, and Brown's not
going
to get much of
anywhere.
Anything. He might have lost a yard on that play as the defense able to sniff that one out.
Well, their Hoss running back's starting
to flare up a little bit.
Their Hoss running back still not in the
game. Yeah, we have not seen Evans. Oh, actually, looks like he is coming back. That does look like Evans. That's it. That is indeed 44. And they have been able to have success on the ground due to him. Yep, he's back in. No gain officially, so second and 10 at the 20. Shotgun set. Weathers drops back, has pressure. He's just going to throw that ball up in the air and incomplete. Had to evade the pressure of number 24, Middleton.
If you notice that, guys, whenever he does have pressure, he's not very accurate and he tries to get rid of it quickly. So when he's got time where he can just heave it downfield, he's got gifted receivers.
Again, it's a hit-miss thing with Weathers. Oh, he only completed 42% of his passes last season. You know, he did throw 14 touchdowns, but again, as we mentioned at the top, he also threw 21 interceptions.
He's got another one here tonight.
So he is indeed, at times, an all or nothing kind of passer. Third
Feast
down, they'll bring pressure. Weathers is going to throw that one up, and that ball is going to be incomplete.
That time, the offensive receiver down there, he was pretty much playing defensive back.
He was. Yeah. Weathers facing pressure, had to throw that one off his back foot. Good coverage on the play by number 18, Jalen Walker. So the Cougars will force a three and out. They'll force Weathers to punt.
Looks like that was a really good call on the part of the offensive coordinator with that punt last time, electing to do that, as Lamarck should get fairly good field position.
Justin Calvin has to feel good about the way his defense has played for most of the evening.
We got two guys back here deep now,
yep,
this time.
That's yep. Preston.
And number six, Jeremy Lamones.
Both of them at around the 45-yard line up Sterling as they await the punt from Weathers.
Whoa.
And that's a bit high. And a line drive that's going to take a very decent bounce for the Raiders.
He's lucky to get that one off.
That ball is down around the 41-yard line. That's a 39-yard punt. Three and out. Cougars get the ball back. Pretty good field position with 8 minutes, 26 seconds left in regulation as we are tied 14-14 opening night.
16-16. No extra point, no extra points kicked tonight.
No, not at all. Kickers have pretty much been quiet. 16-16, your score. It's Miles Lanius is under center. Guidry in the backfield. Evans is the fullback. They'll hand it off to Guidry, and Guidry is going to spin forward. Gets about a 2, maybe 3 on the play. Tackle made by number 2, Brown. And there's a good sign of sportsmanship as he helped Guidry back up. Guidry will get 3 on the carry. So it'll be a second down, 7 to go at the 43-yard line. As we go inside 8 minutes here in the fourth. Both Guidry and Preston well over 100 yards tonight as the ground game really taking the form. Handoff is to Guidry, and Guidry's got room, breaks off a tackle, broke up, almost got past the second one. And Guidry is running like a man, very, very intent on causing damage to his opposition.
Those last two men that hit him, including the one that brought him down, they both felt that hit.
Oh, they'll be feeling that one on the bus ride home. They'll get the ball to the 46.
Right over the top of him.
Gain of 11 on that play for Guidry. Handoff is going to be to Preston. He got hit. Nice individual effort there by Brown as he collided with Preston. Was able to bring him down.
Give him 1 yard, and that may be generous.
First, so we go second down and 9 at the 46.
No wide receivers, guys.
Not at all. We're just playing good old-fashioned Powerball.
Yep.
.637 to go. Preston in motion. And he'll get the carry. He will move the ball close to a first down. Be about a yard short.
No, he's going to be about 3, looks like, guys.
Like about 3, okay.
Yep. Perry Preston on the carry.
I'm about 3. Momentum carrying a little closer. I'm about 3 yards short, so third down, make it 3. Well, at the 40-yard line. It's see if we can convert this here. You can do so. It's also going to add a little more time off the clock as well. Just got to avoid mistakes at this point in the contest. Preston in motion. It'll be a handoff to James, and Shannon James gets the first down.
Boy, that was a quick hitter.
Shannon James on the carry.
Ton of momentum. His best run of the night.
Gain of
that's
going to
put
play,
him down
good for
to the 30-yard line.
Defense for Sterling starting to get a little worn down, guys. You can just tell in their body language.
You play smash mouth like Lamarck has been doing, and it will wear down a defense eventually.
Well, especially on a humid night like this, as we have seen, both teams definitely feeling the effects of cramps. First and 10 at the 30-yard line, 5:22 to go. Preston goes in motion. It'll be a handoff again to James, and James has corner. James is going
to
be close to a first down. Gain of 8, and Shannon James.
Yeah,
with two impressive runs.
These linebackers are getting dinged up, guys.
They are. That offensive line is starting to gel, starting to assert themselves. We've seen they've had their share of mistakes, but really here on this drive, they are really starting to hammer down on an undersized Sterling offensive front, defensive front, I should say. Second and 1 at the 21-yard line. It'll be a handoff to James. James will have the first down. Brought down a host of white jerseys, but he will get just enough to get the first.
Really working that inside game, guys.
4:33 remaining in the game. Tied 16, it'll move the chains. 2-yard run by James will make it a first down and 10 at the 19-yard line of the Raiders with 4:33 to go as the clock starts to tick down.
Looking for a sweep with number 4 around the end, possibly, guys.
James in the backfield. They'll go out of the mean set.
Ah.
And movement, and just when you give them a little compliment, they break yard. And that's going to be a false start, and that's going to be penalty number 11 on the night for Lamarck, which is going to push them back 5.
Come on, this has got to be game-winning drive right here.
So first down and 15 at the 24-yard line.
We got Sterling calling
a timeout. Raiders will take a breather, 4:19 to go in regulation. We'll do it with the Cougs Sports Net. We'll be right back. Timeout. It's going to be first down and 15 for the Cougars at the 24-yard line. Up Sterling. Concerted drive that started at the 40-yard line. It's been all on the ground. Bishop going in motion. I'll be now, as Lonnie is audibling off. You see a little play action here? Nope, it'll be Preston. Preston is going to get about 2, maybe 3 yards on that play as he wasn't really able to turn the corner completely. As the Raiders will make the stop.
Number 4, Perry Preston.
Looks like he'll get the ball to around the 21-yard line. So pick up 3 on that play. Make it 2nd and 12. For the Cougars at the 21-yard line. James in the backfield. It'll be Bishop in motion. It'll be a handoff to James, and James cuts back, and James is going to get the ball inside the 10-yard line. Shannon James stepping up in a big way.
Boy, he's right at the first
Perry
down marker,
Preston
guys.
On the carry.
Little short.
And about a yard short of the first down. Still a nice run.
Gain of 11 brings up 3rd down and 1 for the Cougars.
3rd and 1, short yardage situation. And he'll go at the wing
set
with
Lonnie
Perry.
Going to call his own number here. Yep.
Oh,
right
yeah,
middle,
he's
right
in.
He goes in. Beautiful call. And that's a touchdown.
Give me 5, guys.
Miles Lonius takes advantage.
Yeah,
the, of a tired defense, and
yeah.
Looks like a man, somebody's down.
Defense was not ready for that call.
And it looks like Lonius is down. Looks like cramps have him.
But, you know, I think he's probably smiling down there with cramps.
Well, I don't know.
We'll
cramps
see.
Is a little tough to smile.
We'll go ahead and take the break with 3:06 to go. Cougs Sports Lanius walks off the field under his own power, so they will bring Pedro Rubio in to attempt the extra point.
First time one's been tried tonight.
Exactly.
Well, it's an important one, too.
That is a huge one. Rubio doubling as the center this season.
We saw him get progressively better
and
last year.
And a timeout for the Cougars coming up. 3:06 left. They'll go ahead and take a breather. We'll take the break with them. Lamarck 22, Sterling 16. Coug Sports Net will be right back. So, Lanius will come back in after Cougs use a timeout. Cougs will go for the two-point conversion with Preston in the backfield and Bishop the fullback. Handoff is going to be to Preston. Preston's going to work his way in.
Yeah.
They knew it was coming, but there wasn't a darn thing they could do to stop it.
Oh, yeah.
Preston pulls in the two-point conversion. So with 3 minutes, 6 seconds to go, the Cougars get their first lead of the night at 24-16. Hold on to your hats. Lots of games to be played. Coug Sports Net will be right back. Set for the kickoff is Rubio.
193 this half.
Cougs have rolled up 193 yards of offense here in the second half. 57 on that last drop, so he'll just go for a squib kick. And that will be fielded by number 15, Thomas Reed. He just downed it. So the Raiders will get the ball at the 36-yard line with 3 minutes, 6 seconds remaining.
One thing for certain now, of course, I know it's hot, it's humid, it's late in the fourth quarter, but the defense for Lamarck should be resting.
Black Hat defense has one more stop left in them.
Well, the last two drives, well, the drives in this half have been 10 plays, 10 plays, and 10 plays.
Yeah, so Lamarck has pretty well dominated the second half as far as time of possession.
And Weathers have spent much of the second half under pressure. As he was successful in the first half, he was 6-9 for 103 in the first half. Nowhere near that in the second as he's got pressure coming. He's just going to step up and throw that one away as he got hammered at the end by Jerry Evans and another ball player down. It looks like a Sterling player is cramped. And we'll go ahead and take a break now with 2:59 to go, fourth quarter. It is Lamarck 24, Sterling 16. Cramps 7, Coug Sports
Number
Net will be right for Sterling. Ja'Cory White was the injured player. He's able to walk off the field under his own power, but had difficulty doing so as that ball is going to be caught. I'm going to say a completion by Sawa.
Good coverage.
The reception. Very good coverage as Weathers was able to avoid the blitz and got that ball off just in time.
Clock continues to run at 2:42.
Looks like got a stoppage of play. And they're
gonna wait a minute. They're bringing it back.
Yep.
That's an incomplete pass. Or do we have a penalty?
Nope. Looks like holding.
Yeah, nope. He's back here, the back judge.
Yep.
Said, you want to go?
They're saying incomplete pass.
Yeah, he's giving Jackson off. Well, okay. I guess it's not a penalty.
It looked like it was incomplete.
That's what I thought.
That's why the clock stopped then.
Yep. 2:42 remaining. So a big third down and 10 coming up for Sterling. You got to venture that they will go for it rather than punt and give Lamarck a chance to put the game away on the ground. Four wide receiver set coming up for the Raiders once we get things straightened out. 2:42 to go. You make a great point, Mike, earlier. And the fact that, you know, Lamarck did spot to the 16-0 lead, but have shut them down completely on the offensive side of things while the Cougars have forged 24 unanswered.
I'm not quite sure what the officials are doing down here. They're all
milling
about.
It's an incomplete pass.
It's an incomplete pass.
So
but, you know, it seems
spot
like
the ball and let's go.
Yeah, it just seems like these guys are just wandering around. It's like electric football where you just look at a thing and everybody's just moving around in different directions.
And I still don't understand what they're trying to, unless the, I was going to say, unless the head coach is challenging the call.
Well, there is no challenge in
high school. No, I know it. Well, I know that.
May be explaining it to him because the first thing they did was move that ball up 5 yards, and then they turned right around and moved it back, and I really don't think there was I mean, even we were kind of like wondering what was going on.
All right, get the play clock there going. There we go.
So they pushed that. The issue was adding seconds on the clock, so it's 2:48 now.
Lamar's third down.
They'll bring heat. Screen pass is going to be caught. First down and more by Evans, and Evans has a foot race and loses the football. Oh, whoa!
That was just a plain and simple drop, guys.
Number 25, Kavis Simeon, saw the ball on the ground and was like, hey, look what I found. With 2:35 to go, you look at Evans, and Evans,
he's inconsolable back over there.
He is
not a happy kid.
He fumbled the ball at around an 18, 19-yard line.
Yeah, he had a man closing in on him. He probably wouldn't have gotten into the end zone,
no.
But that was just a straight outright drop.
That was.
That's the kind of right there, guys, you don't want to wake up on Friday morning.
Yep. Mm-mm-mm. Took away a play at least to that 45 yards.
And it was well designed. They knew that Lamarck was going to be rushing six men. Yeah, so he had about 10 or 20 yards of just wide open territory in front of him when he got that reception.
You saw the acceleration that he had. Like you said, he probably wasn't going to win that foot race, but had he held onto the ball, you're looking at around first and 10 inside
the
Lamarck
20. Yeah.
Whew. It's almost like it didn't happen. It just happens quick.
So first and 10 for the Cougars at the 24-yard line with 2:35 remaining. Who's a need to just get a first down or two or put this thing away. Hand off is going to be to James, and James is going to cut back. Stays in the middle of the field. Good job as he'll get the ball to around the 31-yard line. So he'll get 7 yards on that play.
And hang on to the ball.
And James has been a real nice breath of fresh air out here for Guidry
and Preston.
Yep.
Sterling's got two timeouts left. I'm sure they'll probably use them. Lamar can continue to move the ball upfield.
2:06 and counting. Lonius taking his little sweet time to get the snap count off. He'll probably get that thing down to around inside 5 seconds before he'll snap it. 1:52 and counting. He'll waste the snap from Rubio, gets it. Hand up is going to be to James, and James is going to be stuffed immediately. He read that one. And they will use one of the two remaining timeouts. Tackle made by number 52, Quentin White. So the Raiders will use one of their two remaining timeouts with 1:38 left. We'll take the timeout with them. Lamarck 24, Sterling 16, Cook Sports third down and three
back
up at the 31-yard line for the Cougars. 1:38 remaining. You get a first down here. You get that much closer to opening 2016 with the victory. Under center has Preston in motion. It looks like they'll go at Preston, but they smelt it out. Great play by the Raiders as number 54, and we have called his name frequently this evening, Ja'Cory White, read the play perfectly.
And they burned their last time out.
And the Raiders will get the ball back. 1:34 remaining. They'll use their final timeout. We'll take it with them. Cougs Sports Net will be right back.
Now fourth down and six, and the Cougars will have to punt the ball.
As number 18,
they're not
Jaylen
lining
Walker.
Up for a punt.
Yeah,
he finally will get everything together. Just trying to make sure that he got the right protection. He's lined up and around his own 18-yard line. 1:34 left. Back deep for the Raiders, number 2, Frank Brown. Play clock is down to 11. He'll wait the snap. A high snap, but there was movement before he even got it off. So the Cougars are going to put themselves back 5 more yards. Make that a dozen penalties on the night for the Cougars.
Oh, there.
No. Oh, okay.
Wait a minute here. They're clapping in favor
Yeah, it's a mistake. They'll delay a game. No, how is it a delay a game on them? So it's now fourth and one.
Yeah, this one kind of curious, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah, now the way the Cougars are saying it's against Sterling. So it must have been encroachment.
Yep.
The way the referees, yep. So that's a interesting scenario. Now what do you do?
The way you've been pounding the ball all night, I think you take a stab at it.
Do you want to take a timeout here, Jackson?
Yeah, they haven't moved the marker.
Now we're going to have now we're going to have a measurement, maybe.
No.
Or did Jackson ask for it?
On the field.
It's possible.
So now you're fourth and one. Fourth and one at the 33-yard line. They are bringing out the chain.
Yeah, he asked for a measurement.
Lonius has tried this three times. He's been successful twice, including once for a 10-yard gain for a touchdown.
Oh, what do you do here, guys? You try to punt it? You're a yard plus.
Yard plus. I'm going to venture that they'll punt. You don't want to run the risk of something disastrous happening and giving Sterling great field position inside your 35.
And special teams has really been doing a nice job in all kinds of coverage, in both the kick coverage and the punt coverage. So I think I'd be inclined to punt.
It's Sala is back deep for the Raiders as he's lined up right now at the 32-yard line. Still 1:33 to go in the fourth quarter as Lamarck leading 24-16, coming back after a 16-0 deficit in the first quarter.
I'd try to punt it to the sidelines here. Don't give him an opportunity to try to run.
Marker awaiting the snap.
Oh, they're gonna go as long as they can on this. See if they can't pull.
Don't get it high snap, but a wobbler is going to be picked up by Masala at around the 35. And now he is just going backwards. And will end up getting about 4 yards on the return.
After dropping back better part of 10.
Yeah, he probably exerted about maybe 15, 20 yards just to get that four. But with 1 minute, 20 seconds left, the Raiders are going to need 61 yards, and they don't have a timeout.
Okay, I still say you need to bring the heat on the quarterback.
Absolutely.
They've been successful with it from when they've done it in the second half.
I don't know that I'd go that full-blown jailhouse like they did just that last offensive play that fumble occurred.
Keep an eye on number 10, Bobby Davis. It's probably going to be the guy that they will look towards. Davis has had two big catches this evening.
They're down underneath.
Cougars are going to take a timeout. 1 minute, 20 seconds to go. They're going to take a breather. We'll take it with them. Cougs for
1 minute, 20
seconds to go. Cougars will have one timeout left. Sterling out of timeout.
Come on, defense.
They will start first and 10 at their own 39-yard line.
Come on, defense.
Yes, you can't expect this ball to be in the air.
Darius Weathers, a quarterback, drops back, has pressure. He's going to throw this one away.
And that bounced one.
One hopper. As number 17, Jerry Evans applying the pressure.
One play down.
Pass intended for number 44, Clifton Evans.
So
that's the good news. The bad news is they only took 4 seconds off.
So a minute 16 remaining.
Well, if you have four plays and 16 seconds click off and we get it, I'm still okay with that.
Yeah, especially since they can't stop it anymore.
No.
Right.
We're going to go to four wide receiver set. They'll have Evans in the backfield with Weathers. Cook showing blitz. Four-man rush.
Oh, good move.
Weathers drops back, goes long, looks up top of that.
Good play.
Outstanding play by number 18, Jalen Walker.
He's made a couple of nice plays.
He has.
Well, this number 17 on the end, guys.
Jerry Evans.
Yeah, you notice how he just shrugs his defender. I mean, the offensive lineman makes a good move on him.
He is picking up where he left off at the end of last year. Kind of struggled at the start of the year, but around midseason, he finally started coming into form and really shot down the stretch for this defense, and it looks like that momentum has carried over into the 2016 season.
It's obvious he's gotten a lot stronger during the summer break.
Third and 10 at the 39-yard line. Weathers drops back, steps up, throws over the middle. Ball is caught, and a huge hit. Huge hit by Perry Preston. Knocked his helmet off.
Picked up the first down, though.
But still a reception made by number six.
As soon as they set the ball, the clock starts, right?
Actually, Brown with the catch. Yes, it does.
It's rolling.
102 to go, and clock Preston will have to take a play off.
Oh, yeah. Once you take lose that helmet. All right, come on, defense.
Well, there's a shotgun now in an empty backfield. Throws over the middle. That ball's going to be caught. First down and more. Still going. But Sala with the reception down to around the 27-yard line.
Good open field tackle there, but.
But it's going to move the chains. First and 10 at the 27-yard line. A 24-yard completion. Now it's to Masala.
Down to 30 seconds in
clock
the game
ticking,
now.
31 seconds to go. Weathers back, throws it up in the air, and that ball's going to be incomplete.
Yep.
Referee threw his hat because the receiver went out of bounds.
He wasn't forced out.
And so Weathers took another shot by Evans, and he was a little slow to get up. Second down and 10 with 25 seconds remaining. We've got a guy down on the side, Lamar sidelines with cramps. So we will go ahead and take a break, see whether he can get up. Looks like he's going to be able to get off the field under his own power.
Now they've still stopped the clock.
Stops the clock with 25 seconds remaining. If you're a Cougars, you just have to make sure that they do not get in position to let Weathers, who is a pretty solid runner, you know, if you get the ball inside the 10-yard line, Weathers is the type of guy who has the type of speed who can make things happen.
Well, if we get a sack here, the clock will continue to
run.
Oh,
exactly. That's the one thing you want if you're the Cougars. You want to be able to get your hands on Weathers in the backfield.
Boy, and he's gimpy coming up into the.
Yeah, he took a shot on that previous play.
Yeah, he got a hit on the hip or something.
Is that Evans again that got
him? Yeah, it was Evans that got him.
Yeah, he's coming off that side, off this end over here, like a bolt of lightning.
Second down, 10, ball at the 27-yard line. Weathers back, has pressure, steps up, throws, ball is intercepted. Intercepted, and the Cougs will wrap it up.
Number four,
Perry Preston,
Perry Preston
with the pick. A late flag, and it looks like it's going to be against the Ray Sterling player. Perry Preston with the huge play, the play of the night, guys, with an interception with 16 seconds remaining.
Speaking of players of the games.
Whoa.
I would pick you two running backs on offense.
Yeah, I'd go ahead. Yep. I'd say the three running backs, Mike.
Yeah, three.
Because you got to remember, Shannon James is a huge part that go-ahead drive in the fourth quarter.
Absolutely. I agree with that. And guys,
defensively, I got to say Jerry Evans.
I'm going to go the same way, Jerry Evans. Go.
Yeah, he put tremendous pressure on the quarterback most of the night, and it showed in this final drive here. All right. So our first players of the game in this new season.
Your
three,
running
four,
backs.
And five.
Yep.
3, 4, and 5.
DeMarco Guidry, Perry Preston, both of them going over 100 yards tonight. And Shannon James, a huge contribution in the fourth quarter. Defensively, Jerry Evans, he got a sack, but he spent a good part of the second half in the backfield, really slowing down that passing game of Sterling. 16 seconds to go is the best play in football. And Miles Lawney is.
If the score is bigger on your end.
Exactly. And he's going to go victory formation.
There we go,
buddy. He'll just kindly hand the ball to the official.
All right. Give me five. I love it.
It's indeed a wonderful thing.
How about 15 more?
I'll tell go ahead and take that. A little bit rocky beginning of a rocky beginning.
Yep. It was shaky in the first half.
Oh, it was. But the Cougars right at the ship. And were able to pull out a 24-16 victory over a pretty game Raiders team from Houston Sterling.
And we spotted them 16 points in the first quarter, guys.
And
we
did. Turnovers, that's it.
It was, again, you know, very sloppy at times, but the Cougars relying on that ground game as they rolled over for more than about 360 yards rushing tonight.
Talked about it right there at the end of the first half. I said, if you don't win the turnover battle, you're going to be hard-pressed to win a game. Guess what? Cougars came back, wound up being 4-3 in favor of the Cougars.
That's true.
We'll gladly take it. We'll go ahead and wrap this one up. How sweet it is indeed. Final score, Lamarck 24, Sterling 16. We'll go ahead and do this one again next Thursday night. And we'll be back here at Etheridge Stadium. So for Senior Stats, Lewis Perrin Sr., Mike Lockwood, and Lewis Perrin Jr., this is Brandon Williams saying so long from Etheridge Stadium, where the final score on opening night of 2016, it's Lamarck 24, Sterling 16. Good night, Cougars State.